Sure, you've maybe caught a little bit of my content before coming to this one, but I do certainly appreciate it. Make sure, if you're not already a subscriber to the Awesomeo YouTube channel, you do so now. Hit that little bell up in the top right corner to be able to subscribe. Make sure you get notified when these top five videos come out, and of course, our live shows. This is my top five bets, first clicks, for the Masters. And of course, we've already done some content on it, so I'm going to stay away from giving you my favorites, per se. We all know I'm clicking Jordan Spieth to win and starting off my betting cards. But here are some other names, five names to be exact, that I'm going to be adding to my card this week. Of course, as I do each and every week, I make sure that I go down Transparency Corner and let you guys know how my bets did last week. Chesson Hadley, he was a great return. Top 20 for him last week. Paid out just over 4 or 5 to 1. Corey Connors, he had a nice Sunday there, getting into the money for us. Aaron Wise missed the cut. Bernd Wiesberger missed the cut. But Abraham Anser also got into a placement point for us in the top 20. So overall, had three top 20s. A pretty good event in that regard. A positive return. No big return. We're going to start off this week, however, with a guy that came in third place last week and will be his third time around Augusta. It's Matt Wallace. 100 to 1 this week coming in for the win, 14 to 1 on the top 5, 7.5 to 1 on the top 10, and 3.5 to 1 on the top 20. I think you're getting really good value for a guy that says he's playing the best tee to green he's played in quite some time. And in fact, last week he said it was the best tee to green he had played in his entire career. You don't want to fade that, especially at these prices, 100 to 1 for Matt Wallace. My next bet, and of course these are in no specific order, just put them down as guys that I wanted to bet on this next one. I'm bet Lee Westwood, 50 to 1 to win this week. Priced way above guys that are certainly not playing as well as Lee Westwood is. Now, I guess a missed cut at the Honda isn't his best. An 18th at the match play after that. But prior to that, 2 second place finishes in the hardest two stops in Florida at the Arnold Palmer in the Players' Championship has me excited about Westwood here this week. 50-1 win, 8-1 for the top 5, 4-1 on the top 10, and 2-1 on the top 20 for Lee Westwood this week. Of course, if you don't know his Masters form, well, given 38th this past year, then he had a year where he didn't make it, 2019. But prior to that, man, he has some of the best history around these hollow grounds of anybody in the field. So keep an eye on Lee Westwood here this week. Brian Harman, he's the next guy I want to talk about. The lefty that is having an outstanding season. Coming in 5th at the match play, making it all the way there to the Elite 8. And prior to that, had come in 3rd at TPC Sawgrass. So it's really been good for Brian Harman, who comes in 125-1 to win. 18-1 on the top 5, top 10, 8-1, and top 20, 4-1 here this week. Course History hasn't played here for a couple of years and did miss the cut in his last attempt. Next two guys I'm going to talk about, and that'll end this show here. Victor Perez, this guy, and Siwoo Kim, for that matter, both of them are going off at 150-1 to win. While I don't think they can win, if they get themselves into a good form here this week, you can bet on them being in the top 20 at the very minimum, if not the top 10. Shown by Victor Perez now, 9th at the Players, 4th, making it all the way to the Final Four in match play, so showing that upside. They're both the same odds, so 150-1 to win, 20-1 on the top 5, 9-1 on the top 10, and 4.5-1 on the top 20. Perez, he came in 46th here in November. It was his only start, while Siwoo Kim, he's made the trip 4 times, made the cut all 4 times, 34th and 21st in his last 2. Okay, let's go ahead and review quickly. Matt Wallace, 100-1. Lee Westwood, 50-1. Brian Harman, 125-1. Victor Perez, 150-1. And Siwoo Kim, also 150-1. Of course, if you're looking for more bets, this betting video, I've been pretty structured on doing outrights and each ways. While there are so many more options this week, a great resource for you if you're trying to get in on the betting action, check out my full Masters guide and player preview. If it's not already live when you're searching for it, it will be very soon. I'm recording this video, I'm looking at the time, Monday 2:30, right around there. So by this afternoon, I expect it to be up. And of course, with all the bets being posted this afternoon, all of my bets will be added by Monday night tonight. So if you're looking for other ways to sweat specific golfers, I'll give you a ton of options there. Of course, join for live shows. Join the show, PGA DFS Strategy Show with Ben and I. And of course, live before lock, you're going to get Alex Osmo Baker, the head honcho, with Eric and Ben wrapping up the week's work. So until next time, everybody, be sure to check out my other top five videos. The next ones are going to be sleepers, fades, and values. That's on the PGA DFS side. So until next time, everybody, thanks for joining, and we will see you on the other side. Cheers.